beautiful people, and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, as you can tell by the title, we're going to be sharing with you guys how to quit your job in your 20s. So personally, the tips that we're going to be giving are the things that we personally took. So this is coming from our actual experience. So without further ado, keep on watching. So before we get right into the nitty-gritty of everything, I want to share with you guys this piece of information and advice. Before any of the things that we're going to be talking about, I want you guys to grasp the mindset of how you're supposed to be mentally before making a jump like this. Because I want you to be aware that this thing isn't easy. It's not like a walk in the park, but it isn't hard either. It's just challenging. It's just, you have to challenge yourself and you have to walk across a new journey of life. So first, just grasp the mindset. So we're gonna hop right into it with number one, which is abandoning all your wants.
Now, abandoning all your wants, that is one of the major things I see so many people actually need to do, and they really don't want to do it. Now, what we did personally was we abandoned all of our wants and we lived like we were poor for about a year or so. Until everything grew, we really lived right. Like we was poor. Mm-hmm. It was like we didn't party. People invite us to stuff, we'll say we don't have the money even though we had the money.
Right.
We
also didn't put the time towards it too, because I think besides money, it's time too. Like, you don't want to put the time into things that you could be putting time into building yourself.
We hadn't went on a date personally. Ooh. We hadn't went on a date in I think like what,
2-3 years,
like almost 2-3 years. Like, it was none of that. No dates, no partying, drinking heavy, smoking, everything. Like, we did none of that. We partaked in none of it because we were so focused on trying to leave the job that everything else kind of didn't compete with that goal.
Yeah.
So the goal was to quit the job. Of course, we had to achieve that goal at all
by
costs. So everything else that had to be sacrificed was sacrificed. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to talk about number two. Number two is brainstorm and find your niche.
And when it comes to finding your niche, all you want to do is basically find out what it is that you truly admire doing. What it is that you like doing that's enjoyable to you but still makes income for you to work for yourself. And finding your niche can be whatever it is. If you're a person who likes to custom design things, if you're a computer literate person, find ways to make money or build a brand or a business out of digital things.
Definitely find anything you're good at. Focus on yourself. Spend your time and focus on yourself. Find what you're good at while you're living your life like you're poor, you know, following the first step. So just find what you're good at. Understand yourself. Take that time. Learn yourself. And from there, it'll be a lot easier to know what you want to do next, what your next moves need to be.
And what it is that you truly want to brand and make a huge business out of.
Now, the third one is one of the major things, and it's something that we went by heavily. It's actually something I made up, but of course, you know, we just went with it. And that's put yourself on a 2-year goal. So a lot of people say if you want to quit your job, put yourself on a 5-year goal. To me, I'm sorry, that fly is so annoying. I know that fly is so annoying, like, jeez. Don't mind us, y'all. God, this fly is annoying.
Yes.
But anyway, put yourself on a 2-year goal. Most people say put yourself on a 5-year goal. I don't agree with the 5-year goal. Some people say put yourself on a 10-year goal. I definitely don't agree with a 10-year goal. One thing about it, 5 years, 10 years, that's way too long for somebody to be sitting at a job, something that you hate. Also, 5-10 years give you too much time to sit around and lag around. You really want to push yourself. If you want out that job, you're gonna have to spend every single day, every single minute focusing and thinking about how you can leave that job. You don't have time to say, okay, I got 5 years, I'ma lounge around till about 3 years, then I'ma get serious. Well, that's your 2 years right there. So what the plan we're dropping right now is for 2 years for you to leave that job. So
small, starting off small, that was a that's a great thing. He's taught me that in so many different aspects. You can use that smaller time frame in so many different things, even like with exercise. Don't say next month I'm gonna start. No, start next week or start today. So yeah, that's a good tip.
It's no better start time than today. Mm-hmm. Like, don't say I'm gonna start next week. And oh my god, a major one I really don't like, don't start till New Year's.
Yes.
Like, do not start till New Year. New Year, new me, it never works.
Cut it. It's dead.
Throw it out the window. It takes too long. All that time, you think about all that time you wasted. Why waste so much time waiting on New Year's when you could have started back in July and got 6 months worth of experience by New Year's? So now you start New Year's off with 6 months of experience. Now your New Year's on down can actually be great. So why start on New Year's and then just now being great around July, when you can start last July and be great on New Year's? You know, just speed up the process, you know, don't take so long. So with the 2 year plan, this is how we broke it down. I broke it down into 4 6-month periods. So you have 6 months, 6 months, 6 months, 6 months to grow. Every 6 months, you're gonna do something different than you did the last 6 months. And the first 6 months, what you wanna do to start this 2 year growth plan, this 2 year quit your job plan, what we did was we spent the first 6 months paying off all petty debt and exploring ideas. So that's a major one. Like, anything like, and petty debt is like credit card bills, anybody you might know, paying off subscription fees. I mean, anything that you can knock out, knock it out. Pay your phone off. You know, that's a major one. Pay your phone off. Maybe pay your light bill up. Stuff like that. But you want to spend that time. You already abandoned all your wants. So now you can focus on knocking out all of those petty bills. And at the same time, because you want to utilize that 6 months, don't just spend that time saying, hey, I'm just finna work and pay the bills, I'm not gonna worry about that. No, also spend that time and think about exploring new business ideas. Think about what you actually want to do. And not so much on thinking about what you want to do, explore options that are available out there. Because there are so many options. Spend more time on YouTube. Like I always tell people I teach, if you go on YouTube, you'll see where your mindset is at. Like, when you go on my YouTube, the main things you're gonna see is ways how to make passive income, you know, all kind of
money making, educational.
I got a lot of natural healing. Like, there is nothing, you won't go on my YouTube and see a bunch
street
of
fights and yeah. Fucking.
Yeah, you won't go on my YouTube and see a bunch of BS,
right?
Like, a bunch of stuff that won't get me to the goal that I want to be at. You go on her YouTube, you know she used to do locks. You see a bunch of different lock styles. You see a bunch of
vegan opportunities, yeah. Vegan recipes.
Cause you know she did the vegan recipes. She do the hair.
And also some natural healing in there too. Yeah. Camera stuff. So.
Yeah, you see a lot of travel stuff. Mm-hmm. So your YouTube tells a lot about yourself because of the algorithm. It tells you where your mindset is at. So try this. Open your YouTube. See what your YouTube is pulling up right now. And from there, you'll be able to tell, was your mindset in the right place?
Exactly.
What we have for the next 6 months to 1 year, you have save and plan. So what you want to do is, after you paid off that debt, now it's going to make it easier for you to actually start to save money now. So what you want to do is save and plan. So the planning comes in effect with the past step where you actually was exploring ideas. Now you've come up with 100 ideas. Now it's time for you to pick one with one backup plan idea. I keep up to 3 backup plans, but I recommend keep one idea and keep one backup at least, because your first idea might not work. If y'all know us, we started our business with a few other things before we even got to where we are now. So I'm not telling you something I think, I'm telling you something that you should actually take into consideration. So with the saving plan phase, what you want to do is you want to save as much money as you can. Still, don't buy anything. Now, while you looking at that money, do not get tempted to touch it. Please do not get tempted to touch it. It's gonna start looking good, but keep in mind the plan. You might see 5, 6, 7,000 that you might not ever been used to seeing. But understand the goal. If you blow that money, if you start going back to the materialistic habits, you're gonna end up blowing that money, and then you're gonna be back at square one. So you don't wanna do that. The next 6 months, what you have is launch your business in the trial and error phase. So you successfully went 1 year with thinking of ideas,
planning,
saving, and stuff like that. So now you done spent that whole year on that. Now it's your first year, you launch your business. Now it doesn't, you take all that money that you accumulated and you launch your business and you invest in yourself. Now you don't wanna wait until the business is perfect. Now your business will never be perfect starting off.
Never.
You will never have everything 100% figured out when you start off. Reason being is you don't know what you're doing until you start doing it.
Exactly.
So you might think you may know, but you will not know. You may talk to people about what they may know, but still you won't know until you start to do it yourself. I mean, even with this video, it's not 100% for everyone, but you have a much better chance doing it this way. So with that, launch your business. Don't worry about failing. You are in the trial and error phase. Spend that 6 months investing. You're gonna lose money. You're gonna lose more than you make. But you do not quit your job yet. You keep that job. You're going to lose more money than you make. I'm telling you this from experience. But keep going. This is the period where most people start their business and then they end up quitting before the 1 year is even up. Most businesses do not last a year. And that's why, because they start to lose more than they are making. That's why you save up way more than what you think you need. Don't invest too heavy in stuff either, because plans change. So, trial and error phase. That is very important to know. That's something that a lot of people really don't talk about. They don't like to tell you
that it is a trial and error phase. They don't like to tell you that you're gonna be disappointed a few times in the first year because you're figuring it all out. So don't be scared of it, honestly, don't fear it. The trial and error phase is honestly the funnest part of the whole business thing in general. We still remember our trial and error phase. Now we look back, when Facebook show us our memories, we look back and we laugh, we enjoy it because we had a really good trial and error phase. It was fun.
And honestly, our business really still in the trial and error phase.
Even
with our business being where it is and us having multiple businesses, you will never be done learning. You're never done learning. Why? Because the market is always changing. People want different things every year. You have two options. You can adjust to those people's wants, or you can try to stick to what you know. Stick to what you know. If you stick to what you know, eventually your knowledge will become obsolete. But if you move with the trend, you will never be obsolete. You know, you'll always have something people actually want. They don't last because they're too stubborn to move with the trend. You have to move with the trend.
Also, another thing with the trial and error phase is the fact that you're learning how to go about your business in a different aspect. So you learn new ways to do things, what to do and what not to do, which leads us into the next one, is reevaluating your plans and evolving your business.
Yeah, definitely want to reevaluate. Take all the knowledge that you learned within that first year to the half a year, first year to the year and a half, I'm sorry. You wanna take the last steps. Get everything that you have learned within the trial and error phase and reevaluate that until your next coming year. Any changes that needs to be made, make them. You don't have to wait until that period hits. You can be making those changes in the trial and error phase also. But any major change that needs to be changed, make sure that it's changed. That way your business will become way more profitable. This is the part where your business becomes more respected and more profitable, because now you've passed the 6 month mark. People not looking at your business anymore as, oh, they just
selling stuff out their trunk.
Yeah, they just selling stuff out the trunk. They just playing around. They not finna take
fast
it serious.
Fast money option.
Yeah, they're gonna treat it with more respect now because you've been open more. You've gained more customers now. Your social media has gained more followers now. So people are promoting you more for you instead of you promoting you. You know, you got your customers promoting you now. So you in a very good stage right now. You at the year and a half to 2 year mark. Now the plan was to quit your job in 2 years. Now you might realize, okay, we in this phase, when do I quit my job? That brings us to the next step. After you've successfully went 6 months, 6 months, 6 months, 6 months, now you're at 2 years. Now what you wanna do is, after you hit the reevaluate your plans and evolve stage, try it out for those whole 6 months. If it is profitable enough, let me repeat that. If it is profitable enough, go ahead, and it's okay to go ahead and quit your job. And when you quit your job, make sure you have enough to handle all your bills and everything. Make sure you have enough to, you know, keep yourself stable for a while. But the reason why you wanna quit your job, this is the major reason why you wanna quit your job around that period, around the 2 year mark, after you got everything set up. That next year is gonna be full of you continuously expanding your business. Give your business that same 10, 8, 10, 12 hours that you was giving that job. If you give it to your business now, your business will have so much more time to grow. You cannot grow your business that you put so much time, money, and effort in if you still giving a job over half your day. You know, you can't give a job that much time and then go home and only work on your business you've been working on for 2 years for 30 minutes or an hour. Like, it just don't work like that. It won't grow. And eventually, you're going to be cutting. You're going to be losing more money than you're making. Mm-hmm. Because the business is going to pay, the job is going to pay you what it want to pay anyway.
Exactly.
I don't care what you make. Your job is going to pay you what it wants to. Your business is more risky. But if you put the time into it, your business will pay out way more than what your job could ever hope to pay out.
Exactly.
Your job is not gonna respect you that way. You're not gonna get 100K a year working a job. I always tell everybody, like, if you wanna be a millionaire, you don't become a millionaire working for a millionaire.
Exactly.
I've never seen a millionaire work for a millionaire. It just doesn't happen. If you wanna be a millionaire, you hang around other millionaires, you get tips from other millionaires, but you do not work for them. And that's an unwritten rule, but I mean, it's just really it's something I go by, so, you know.
And it works.
Yeah.
Like I said, everything that, but we discussed in this video where our experience, things that we took, things that we learned. So I feel like it's no better way to give this information than to give you guys our true, authentic experience.
Mainly what we doing right here is we're giving you our experience to how we grew our business to where
and
it
how
is.
We quit, you know.
A lot of people who know us back in America, of course, y'all know us personally, and y'all know we were not in this situation at first. One thing we never did, we never complained about supporters. We didn't have any supporters once we started our business. So that's another thing. Don't worry about who supports you. Make them support you.
Like I said in the beginning, literally you have to have this drive for yourself. You can't depend on people on Facebook supporting you. You can't depend on the fact that you're doing stuff for your kids. You literally have to have that mindset and that drive in oneself to make all this happen.
You gotta have that mindset, that patience, and that discipline.
Yes.
Because like I said, if you quit your job before it's time, it's not gonna be good. Like, you wanna be an entrepreneur, but if you quit your job too early, you're gonna mess yourself up worse.
Exactly.
So, you know, just avoid that at all points. I don't care how much you feel like you hate it. Use that job to get to where you need to be.
I was just about to say,
because even in my job, in my last meeting, I told my boss, he asked me, I still remember that. It was around evaluation where they let you know how you were doing for the year. He asked me, what was my plan? What was my goals for my job? I said, well, really, I already achieved my goals. He said, what was your goal? I said, I wanted to use the job to fund my business enough to where it's profitable. He said, okay. So you already achieved it. I was like, yeah. So he asked me what was my business website and stuff like that. So of course I gave him, you know, that information. Cool guy said, you know, support, stuff like that. And I just went from there. 3 weeks later to a month later, I think I was gone. I was gone. I don't even think it was a month after that. I was gone. I mean, I didn't wait till, I don't think I even waited till a bonus. I left because the business was already doing so much. It was no point in me sitting around staying.
Like you said before in one of the stuff, you want to give your business those 8 to 12 to 10 hours or whatever that you gave to the job, you want to get into your business. And once you're able to do that, your business will flourish if you just stay focused and continue to utilize the steps that we gave you guys.
I'm sorry. Let me draw one more. Also, this is what I did also within that first year. I hated that job so much, but I spent the whole year, I spent a year and a half before that on the paying off debt part and saving. I worked all the overtime I could. As much as I hated being there, I worked all the overtime I could. The checks was freaking crazy. But I did not buy one single chain. I did not buy one single pair of Jordans. I didn't buy not one outfit. I didn't go out to eat. I didn't do any of that because the need, the urge to leave that job was so great. I wasn't trying to blow anything. I spent most of my time at work. All the money, we saved it and we kept reinvesting. Every time I got that check, I would reinvest it. I'll pay the bills and spend some more on our business so it can continue to grow. Get new inventory and all that. So definitely
make sure you be focused. You invest into your business, into yourself. If you're gonna spend some money, after you save all that money, if you're gonna spend something, it needs to be invested into you.
Yeah.
You only spend money to invest into you. You don't spend money for to look good or to feel good. You wanna spend money to invest in oneself so that you won't have to work anymore.
Why look rich when you can be rich? I didn't buy a single car. Even if we get into like numbers and stuff, we've had 20,000-30,000 in the account
after everything was paid,
Bills paid, and we have bought zero new cars. No new cars. We didn't buy a new house. We didn't buy new furniture. We didn't do anything. We literally lived like we were broke the whole time.
Well, technically we did get a house.
The house was a business investment. Yeah, it was just us two, but we had to get, you know, a nice size 4-bedroom 2-garage. Of course, we had to get that. We still got it still, but that was a business investment because by then the business had grown so much that we had to get more room. You know, a 2-bedroom apartment can't house a whole business bringing in what we brought in. So when you look
in terms of like buying a new house, it needs to be something that can benefit your business. Don't buy a new house to have a guest room. Buy a new house to have an office or a storage room.
We didn't have any guest room. We had rooms in the house like crazy, but
every room
made money. I call it like I say every room in this house worked, everybody in this house worked, everything in this house has to work. Mm-hmm. Our money has to go to work. You don't work for the money, let the money work for you.
Exactly.
So with that being said,
we really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any more questions and want a more detailed video on things specifically, drop it down in the comment section.
Yeah, we really didn't want to make the video too long. I think we probably did, but I think they're going to enjoy this content. You know what I'm saying? Good luck, everybody. Like, for real. Like, I want to wish y'all good luck on starting your business. Good luck on your 2-year journey. I hope all of you take this down into consideration. Write it down, note it down, and actually go back. And 2 years later, I want to actually hear from a lot of y'all how your success went. Now, if you do it in a short amount of time, hey, kudos. Let us know. Let us know. Like, hey, I followed y'all's steps, but I cut this out, cut that out. Hey, if you cut some steps out, hey, and it worked. I can't knock you for it. You know, we'll just give you, that's what we did. It was a little tough with this. That's what we did. If it didn't work, just keep on trying. Just keep trying. Keep in mind, you're only in your 20s. Stop letting social media fool you, thinking everybody gotta be millionaire, billionaires by freaking 20. That's just not realistic. You're not finna. it's not for everybody. It's not 100% for everybody. You might not hit it till 30s. But if you never try, you go end up working till you 60, 70.
Exactly.
So you got plenty of time to retry. Yeah. I gave you a 2-year plan. You think of how many 2 years you got before you 60, there's no reason why you will fail.
Exactly.
You got too many times to keep trying. So with that being said, peace family, love y'all, continue watching. If you like this content, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon. Hit the bell icon down below so you can get notified for all our videos, and we will be dropping more financial videos, growth videos and stuff like that. If that's what y'all into, you know, we'll try to expand the content a little more. You got anything?
I don't think I have anything, so yeah. I already said what I had to say a few.
I'm sorry. One more thing. Yeah. You gotta say support the business, of course. Support the business. www.blackbyc.com. You know we got the best shea butter, cocoa butter, shampoos, hair oils, black soaps, anything you need. We have the best suppliers of the stuff. Like, and y'all know me, I keep everything 100% natural. I work hard for that. A lot of research went into our products to make sure we only give y'all the best products. It's none of that buy a thing of shampoo in bulk and pour it into bottles and then just sell it. No, it's none of that.
We have an actual formula that we go by and we create it.
Yeah, it's a formula we create from scratch, and it took a while. Like, it was in our stages as well with the learning stage.
So yeah, like you were saying, support the business. That's a form of supporting us. And without further ado, we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.
Hey guys, I just wanted to let you know that if you do want to help support the channel, you can do so by checking out our website, where we supply raw natural ingredients like black soap, shea butter, cocoa butter, etc., as well as our own hair and skincare line. But I don't want to bore you with all the specifics, so go ahead and just click that link in the description box below, and I'm sure we have something for everyone.